Hi everyone, this is Amy. Today I'm going to be doing a tutorial on her skin. This is the Halloween Twilight and Jasmine Beckett Gritz coloring book of fantasy art adventure. Alright, I'm going to be using, I'll get these out in the open right now, sepia and clay rose for low lights, pink for a little bit on her skin, light peach, seashell pink, and peach. Alright, I'm going to start with her low lights in her face. This is just copied paper off of cardstock, scanned it into the computer. I'm using light peach, just doing, not pressing too hard, just some light. Around her cheeks. And then on the forehead. Going all the way down to her eye. Her eyebrows. I do a circular motion. It's the way my mom taught me to color way back when I was just a little kid. If you do lines, it'll be streaky. You don't want streaky. Alright, so I'm going to do under her chin, on the nose, just a little line across there, and then right here, go up a little bit on the chest. Arms. I'll actually bring out some yellow too. She's got some yellow from the highlighting from the pumpkin. Just gonna do a little bit of highlight here. I'm gonna keep it nice and close. And her hand should be highlighted too. I'm gonna grab that out really quick. I have 132 set. Lots of variety. I'm going to grab lemon yellow. We're just going to do some simple yellow right alongside on her thumb. Get her to glow a little bit. Not through that arm. We're not going to do hair, otherwise I'd do it in the hair right now too, but I'm only doing skin tone right now. Okay, so light peach is done. Now I'm going to move on to the peach. Just regular peach. I'm going to go all over. Pressing a little harder on spots that I want a little bit more low lights, which is pretty much right up through here. Travel down the arm, not so hard. A little lighter. down through here. Let me take my light peach and do down here. See, there's a highlight here. Do a quick swap. I have all my colored pencils next to me, all handy. Alright, same thing on this arm. You don't want to go over the light peach. Just going right where you didn't color already. Pressing a little harder up here. It'll be a lot less peach after I'm done. That's what this seashell pink is for. Gives it a little bit more natural skin color. Okay, now through the neck. Not pressing too hard, only in areas that I want. Right around that hair, there'll be a shadow. Excuse me. Then up through here. Try not to turn the page sideways. Alright, don't forget her ears. That one looks pretty covered. I'm just going to take my light. Again, do the tip of her ear. Gonna give her that little square nose. Around here, just a little bit darker. So we're gonna add all the highlights or the low lights anyway. Looks kind of messy right now, but that's okay. We're going to color it with taking my light, just doing a few little soft touches there. A little darker in the middle, under the nose too. Right under that lip. Go up through this right here, carry that through. Just kind of doing the spots I haven't got done yet. Right around the hairline is going to be a little darker too. Alright, I'm going to turn the paper, I'm sorry, just a little bit. And this I kind of want a little bit streaky. So this, I'm going to go right where I want that. Not too hard, but a little harder, kind of like what you did up here. You still have a few colors to go over. And then just to blend it, just a really light, kind of blend it up into the forehead just a little bit. Turn it back. This I'm gonna do kind of light. All right, there's the peach. I'm gonna take seashell pink and I'm gonna go over it, all over. The light peach, I mean, you see the color difference already. Light peach and the peach. This I'm not pressing hard, just enough to get the color there. So it's a little bit more human and not so pink. And it blends it pretty well too. And keeping that yellow there. It just goes all over. These colors work for me very well. Some people may not like them together. I personally love them. This is kind of my go-to skin tone for a white Caucasian, what I'm going for. I do have a dark skin. I haven't got a tutorial yet for that, but I might eventually do that. Blend. Again, we're going to go over everything. Even pressure is good. Alright, that looks to be all over. So now, I'm going to take Clay Rose and we're going to do her low lights. Do right around here where the dress line is. And we're going to define her arm a little bit here. Just kind of go in. A little bit here. Kind of dark where that pumpkin's going to lay. On her arm. Okay, right in between the fingers. Nice little shadow there. Same with the pumpkin. Same spots on here. find her arm again. Darken this side. This side's all lit up. Give her hand some definition there. Maybe a little on her thumb. Kind of bring this in a little bit. Define that. Okay. I'm going to go up through here. This is always dark. Right underneath that chin. It's got a nice shadow. You kind of go light down, you want the hair. Give her a little shadow there by that hair. And again, by the dress. Do a little one here. Not too noticeable. Just a little bit. Right here by that hair again. It's always a nice shadow. Over here is going to be dark. And that ear, make sure to get that ear a little dark too. This one too. They're hidden. Not too far down. A little bit. Can always do right here too. Define that or her eye a bit more. Define over here. Underneath her eyebrows. Okay, we're going to go ahead and do her nose. This is right at the top. Right on those sides. So you're making that all square. And on the sides. I want that defined. Bring that out just a little bit. And then right in the middle. Bring under the side here. By the nose. And give her a little... Because of her nose sticking out, there's going to be a hint of a shadow there depending on... The light's coming in just like that. So you might have a little shadow right underneath that nose. Again, same under her lips. Her chin a little defined there. Up through her lip. Make her lip stick out just a little bit. And then right on the sides. This is pretty typical on most of Jasmine's stuff. On where you'd shadow. Yeah, this works on most. A little bit more shadow there. Press light. You can always go back if you don't like it. Or if it's too dark, it's hard to fix. Alright. So we got over here. Did over there. Alright. Trace her... The hairline right here will give it a nice little shadow. You want that kind of dark. Alright, and I'm going to turn the paper just a little bit again. I'm going to do right at that. Some people like to define her nose a little bit. I don't. Not normally. It's cute though. It's a good idea. Go up just a little bit into that eyebrow again. If you press too hard when you're coloring in the book, you may rip it a little bit. So be careful on that. Don't press too hard. I've done that so many times. I'm just going to go down on the nose, the bridge of the nose, just a little bit more. And then up on that nose just a little bit too. Okay, that's how she looks so far. Now we're going to add some sepia to the same spots we did, just darkening them up a little bit. At first I started out using a black highlight. Yeah, it was a bad idea. Much happier with sepia. Angle light. You don't want to press too hard with this one. Unless you're looking for a nice dark brown. This is just shadow work, so you don't want too hard. Over here. I'm going to go right by that pumpkin again to really darken up her arm right there. Give it a nice big shadow. It's a pretty big pumpkin. Right over her hand. Give that a little shadow right there. And then up here, you're going to want kind of dark. You can press hard right up through here. And then kind of press a little lighter as you go down into the picture. I'm going to take a little black after this too, after I'm done with the sepia. Okay, right here too. It'll be a nice little shadow there. Over here. Maybe a little off her shoulder too. Right around the hair. Right around the shirt. Dress. Alright. And now onto her face. We'll do back over here again. Darken that up. Maybe here too. I think she's got a lot of yellow through here. I'm not going to do that right now. I can always go back and do that later if I finish this picture or not. Just I'm going to press a little harder. Get out a little bit more definition back there. It is her ear, but it's kind of buried. So you don't want it too bright. You want it darker than here. Okay. Same up in here. Pressing kind of light. Still. Define our hairline. A little bit by our eyebrows. Hit the chair. Alright, down by the nose. Give it that little... The moment you realize, this is definitely not the look you You have a dark and then light around there. You want to lighten that shadow up. Okay. And then under here again. Upper lip. Go for a little under. I darken this up a little too much, but that's okay. I'll work with it. I can always go over it with the white if I don't like it. Define her underneath the chin, underneath the lips. You want them to pop. Give her a little chin. A little bit of shadow underneath it. Darken that just a little bit. Alright, so I personally don't, I think I did this a little too much. So I'm going to take the white and just kind of blend over it so it's not there. A little better. Not so noticeable. I do have a little brush. Move all that out of there. There's one more spot. I don't know. That was probably from the pencil. You can just take your white. If you think you've gone over it a little too much, take your white, even it out a little bit. There. That looks a little better already. This white is an awesome little blending tool. Use my holder here quick. Some highlights in there. You can take this and go over all the light areas. You can do a little bit up here too. It blends really nicely. Went a little dark right there. My hand just lightens up her skin. To go back here. Alright, so the only thing I have left, I'm going to turn my paper just a hair, is this spot right here. I'm just going to define it so I know where I'm going. A little darker. Again, if you go too hard, it might eat up your page. Be careful. Don't press too hard. This is not. The cardstock, it's fine. I could probably press a lot harder if I really wanted to. And see, that's a little dark for me. So I'm just going to go over it. Lighten it up just a hair. You can press nice and hard on the white. It'll turn back to white. Nice little nifty trick with this. I'm gonna use maybe a little more white. I'm just gonna circle it up here. Kind of really blend that. Blend through here a little bit too. Turn it again. See, I mean, it took the color right there right off. So I just want to blend it back in. And go a little bit more on it. Took off a little too much. This white is good for that. If you mess up, just use the white. Or an eraser. That helps too. I'm just kind of blending our forehead so it looks not streaky. You can do this to your cheeks too. Anywhere you feel like it needs to blend. This is a little streaky over here. Just take it and blend it. Alright, she looks pretty awesome so far. Now, I'm going to take the pink. Give her a little pink in that cheek. Not too far out. Just a little pink. And then I'm going to take my black. I got little nubs on my white and black. I use these a lot. I'm going to turn the page one more time. I'm going to just go really lightly around this and darken this up just a little bit more. I mean, if you really want your highlights and lowlights defined, use the white and black. They're good for this. And just kind of blend that a little bit more into there. You know what? I'm going to try blending with the light peach. Maybe that might help a little bit. Oh, yeah. A little bit better than the white. And then you can go over it again with the seashell. Just so it blends really nice. And I think she's done. Thank you guys, and hopefully see you on the next tutorial.